Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Briarius Kerensky here for a first hour play on the Wii U. This video is about StarFox Zero, a game that came out at the moment I record this video about a week ago. And to be honest, I don't know if this will ever reach you. I'm doing this video as some sort of buffer. Hopefully there is no patch. There is no patch. Thank you. To have a continuous stream of videos that will bridge some of the unboxings, and some of the first hour plays I've done. So these might either end up being a buffer for a small gap or an end to a rather long stream of days where I continuously uploaded videos, or you will probably never even see it. So, reviews for this have been out already, they haven't been spectacular, but I thought that, well... Okay. So yeah, I'm holding the Wii U pad near the mic. Do a barrel roll. So, right now this one feels like StarFox the turret shooter, which is not exactly a good thing. But I guess it would be hard to... get through. So one thing I'm noticing that when I break the R-Wing doesn't open its air brakes. Something that was in the previous version of StarFox 64. can't do a flyby of the great fox. I have rings to pass through. I mean, it's not like this is making me remember Superman 64. Absolutely not. Well, it controls better than that game. So one thing I'd say about this boost is that it doesn't really give you the feeling of boosting. Oh, it's banking automatically. Is that enough, Peppy? So yeah, to reiterate something I've just mentioned earlier, I still think that the SNES original is the best Star Fox there is right now. Yeah, this boost feels very calm, let's say. Are we done yet? So I think you are missing all of the dialogues that are coming through the Wii pad. Okay. So I'll skip the training.
The name's Fox. Fox McCloud. I'm the leader of Star Fox, an elite fighter squadron established by ex-Cornarian flying ace James McCloud, my father. 5 years ago, my father was hired by General Pepper of the Cornarian Army to investigate strange activities on planet Venom. He never returned.
I think that
despite
every
being a backwater little rock
game
in space,
resets
Venom had become the base of
universe.
Operations for Andross, a crazed and banished scientist. Three pilots flew out on that mission.
Well,
my
not
father,
every,
James,
but,
his best friend and wingman Peppy Hare,
looks like,
and Pygma Dengar, an honorless slimeball who volunteered for the assignment.
From Star Fox 64.
Turns out
it
Pygma was working for Andross
the
whole time. No one
Fox
saw it
Command.
Coming. Pygma betrayed Peppy and my father and led them straight into a trap. In the chaos that followed, my father sacrificed himself to create a diversion so Peppy could escape. Barely making it home with his life, Peppy knew it fell upon him to report the courageous last moments of James McCloud. At the same time, he delivered the news that Andross had amassed a terrifyingly huge army and intended to conquer the entire Lylat system. And so began the Lylat Wars.
Which was the subtitle of the European version of Star Fox 64.
5 years have passed. The battle between the Cornarian army and Andross's forces is spreading to every planet in the Lylat system. To carry on my father's legacy, I brought Star Fox out of retirement. I've got the latest technology, and I'm filling the team with pilots I know I can trust.
Slippy Toad?
Slippy Toad, a close friend and a gifted mechanic. Falco Lombardi, a hotshot flyboy who's got your back when the going gets tough. Peppy Hare, my father's old wingman, a seasoned pro and the glue that holds the team together. That brings us to today. While en route to planet Cornaria, we received an urgent message from General Pepper. Apparently, Andross's army appeared out of nowhere and launched a full-scale attack on our once peaceful capital. Now's our chance to honor my father's legacy and restore the Star Fox name. You hear that, Andross? We're coming for you!
Yeah, I guess. So I have maxed out the Wii U pad speakers. I see that the microphone is picking up the sound. So I'm doing this with the motion controls. Yeah, I went through training, thank you. Can we start the game? that I am replaying the first stage of StarFox 64 with IDEF graphics. I mean, fan pandering is one thing. I don't know if I just found a secret. So I'm looking at the pad now. Thank you, Falco. Thank you. switching between screen and pad. I've read about that. Not the biggest fan of this right now because I don't really get to see where you were going. Androsa. I use my motion controls when I have a reticle. Miss the Super NES original and things like that. Especially that on the first SNES game, Sleepy added this high-pitched voice. Well, even from the pad... Oh, good luck. Even from the pad, I can hear the stereo sound, the stereo effect. So one thing I've lost... So I've lost my double laser, I see that my teammates' shields have been replenished. yeah, this is similar to a stage in StarFox 64. It looks terrible. Semi-reticle. At least if you just watch the screen isn't the best, you actually need to glance down to the pad. These foot sections aren't exactly the best. It's like they are a bit tackled on into the game. And that's down. So yeah, I guess I'm having fun with this. But... yeah, I can see that it is by Platinum, but definitely it's not their A-team that work on this. Wonderful 101 and Bayonetta 2 are much better games right now. No! Ah, okay. I don't want to use the walker. All I want from StarFox is to fly around. I never really liked even the Landmaster and the submarine in StarFox 64, to be honest. What will be helpful in these all range battles? A radar to show where the enemy is and where the boundary of your area is. What I'm doing. Yeah, I mean, it's fine that you say this, but... the fact is that... There are no indication on where he is in space, I mean. I haven't noticed that I took so much damage, in fact. No, not again. Shut up, Falco. That the aileron roll slash dodge in this mode is mapped to the R stick that you also need to turn. Yet another vehicle. So I'm driving, well, it looks like Rob, but from the Wii U pad. Well, they have a Mecha King Kong now. This way, big thing, this way. so, and I'm stuck with that thing? Can't I have my R-Wing back? Pretty, pretty please? It's weird that the sound of the propellers is coming from the Wii pad. Stealth missions? Really? Okay, and what now? Yes, oops. I don't really know what to do with that bomb.
Thank you.
What? That went better than expected. So yeah, StarFox is like Sonic in terms of furry friends at every game. So, while I think it's not bad, it's not good either. I mean, controls could be smoother. And in fact, these sections could not even exist completely. That's a nice craft. Well, see you, Foxy Lady. Yeah, that was intentional. Sorry. Yay! Were those enemies from the original Starwing? Or StarFox, sorry. Oh no, I... Oh, okay. No, those are enemies from Star Fox 64, not the original. So you know that right now the biggest mistake this game is doing is that it's trying to do too many things. Well, essentially it should be Star Fox, it's a rail shooter if you want. hopefully I'm done. No shit, Rob. Yeah, with this thing, I can fall behind a turtle. So yeah, I'll cut this video here at the end of this mission. Hey there, Foxy Lady. So, as I said earlier, I think that StarFox should go back to its Super NES or even Nintendo 64 origins. Not trying to do all this stuff together. I mean, it's fine, but right now it's clearly underdeveloped. Controls could have been better. They are not bad, and the game is not bad, but it's not good either. That's this game's problem right now. Great, more aching. Great. So, well, I hope you've enjoyed this video, if I'll ever publish it, and you stick around for more. Briarios Kerensky, over and out.